looking shot wise. We lined up good. Friends and family, thank you so much for being here today. I know it's a little cool out, but isn't it amazing? It's February, you're sitting at the beach, and you're witnessing one of those magic moments that's just going to really, it's going to stay with you all the days of your life.
How long have you known some of these folks?
Long time.
Alright, is there anyone here that you know longer than the one standing in front of you?
No.
Isn't it amazing how people come into our world? How we write on the pages of people's lives, writing on their lives. Even before the other may have come into the picture, you've been there to influence them in some way or another. And sometimes the people who are in our world, well, they help influence us to be who we are. So if in any way, shape, or form, you help them to be who they are, now the one standing in front of them finds it attractive, that means today is partly your fault. But in the days, in the weeks, the months, the years, and even the decades to come, they will thank you for being a part of their story, and it continues right now. The rest of the comments are right here.
Oh.
You made it!
Yeah!
Does it even seem possible that 6 years have flown by?
Yeah.
Well over half a decade, and it's amazing how technology can cause us to reconnect. But you can chat online for a while and you can kind of rekindle that you didn't even know was there. Go back to high school. How many times would you pass in the hall and not even realize that that would be the person one day you'd be making forever promises?
No idea.
Wouldn't it be fun to go back in time for a moment to see yourself back then and just to go, you know that person over there you're going to marry one day. How did all that time pass? But I also want you to ponder all the years since high school and think of all the good things that have happened to you. Now think of all the bumps in the road that have happened to you since even the bad times. I'm thankful for everything that's happened to you in the world because it made you who you are. And if you weren't who you are right now, you may not be ready to receive the truth. And it's so important that we realize that all the time that's happened, all that's happened in our world, that sometimes when it all is able to look back on, we realize it all happened for a purpose. You're ready now to receive the person in front of you. You're ready to say, that's the person I want to spend the rest of my days with. And you have to go back, never knowing where the significant moments will be.
You know this is going to be a significant moment.
You know, the Disney was going to be a significant moment.
That's so dumb.
Not at all. That's just, you never know where the greatest things in the world are going to come from. And you can look back and go, you know what? If nothing else happens, if it goes nowhere beyond that moment, at least it's a fun place to be. Then something would happen. Be a first kiss. Do you remember the first kiss? There's butterflies, there's that moment. Why? You're going to be kissing in just a moment. We're all going to be looking and she's going to be taking pictures. But you know, that first kiss is not the last kiss. And the next kiss will be a cousin. And the rest of your days will be spent in. How will you spend the rest of your days? I don't mean with what will you be doing. But how you make it the rest of your days is to realize that you're either going to grow together or you're going to grow apart. And you're choosing today to grow together. You have to hold on tight. There's 7.5 billion people in the world. 6 years ago, you realized that I want to hold on to this person. Now, today you may want to talk the person away. That happens. We generally still hold on so that when they do ask that question, we don't want to let go. We want another moment. And you know, I love being out there in this park, but then look at the rocks out here. Do you remember the proposal? Remember the rocks on the left? Remember that day when you say, would you
I'll ask that question.
How do you answer that question?
Is that going to shake up the rest of the day, though? But I think it's going to end well. Because the two of you have found a love that is so powerful that even Scripture itself describes that love. Think about it for a moment. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it just uses the word love over and over again. But hear how you should be one to the other. Just as it says the word love, look at your holy name. It says love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not selfish. It is not easily angered, it is no record of wrong. It does not delight in evil, it rejoices, it pleases, it always protects, it always hopes, it never gives up, it always persists. It says this type of love never fails. That love you've surrounded yourself with family and friends and good memories and moments, you found somebody who needs that description of love. You want to hold on to it for the rest of your day. That's why you come to this place. And you will not forget your anniversary date. How can you? You're right, too. Well, that's right. This is that first moment we started out on the journey. If you really tell everybody that's what we did. Because it's your journey as husband and wife. And it's the journey of all the way back to high school. And that bend down the hall. A reconnecting with dates and memories and moments that have led to over a half decade. Things you know each other. But you choose each other. Out of that 7.5 billion we can look back and realize that there are folks out there, they may only come into our life for a chapter or two. We found somebody who wants to be there all the time. That's one of the greatest things in the world. That's why you come here to make these promises, tested by time. Where they began, I don't know, but they're yours today. I'm going to take the flowers and I'm going to take your hand. Simply repeat these words.
No.
Oh, no.
Well, I bet it's hard.
Simply repeat these words. Today, I take you to be my lawful wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in love, honor, and charity, with all that you both have been. These words are not said lightly, but spoken from the heart. These words tested by time, I don't know where they begin, but today they are His words. Promises and covenants and seals, and these things do not fail. Because truly, this is one of those days of judgment in time. You know that it's going to rise tomorrow, and the next day, and the next day. And every day the sun rises, the Lord reminds you of the promises and seals of the church that the Lord has given you. Or the pictures that you have, and those reminiscences that you have, they remind you. Thank you.
circles represents eternity. It's how long your love will last. The rarity of the metal, how rare we find the precious stones, how precious the time is that you should pay your time to drink. And they may go on and off their hand a thousand times. Maybe they have to be repaired or resized. That you are spoken for, that you are loved. They say that there is a pain that runs in the ring finger in every little part of the mind. I'm going to have to move just a little bit because you can't trust me. You're going to wonder why you have a picture of his leg. That's all good. This gift.
I'm doing a video for him.
Forever stop following after you. Where you go, I will go. Your people will be my people. God will be my God. My love. And with this ring, I give it to you.
With that gift you walk in, you know that it has so much to do with it. They be assembled for all time. The love of the
beauty of the relationship.
You know, just as it's beautiful, come up and find it. You're not using it back. It's a rare find, just as the hand is holding. Because that hand that holds your hand. It will nurture you, it will protect you, it will build a world of good things. It will love you, it will support you, it will feed you, it will be there all of your days. Now, that same symbol is placed upon you. You put them on the place that man upon you, more than you, but you upon you. Now, with these same painful words, simply repeat after me. Ask the Lord to be with
you. Ask the Lord to be with you.
Forever stop following. Where you go, I will go. Where you go, I will stay. Your people will be my people.
Your people
will
be my people.
Your God will be my God. I pledge my love. And with this ring, I pledge. Is this a good deal getting each other's people?
Yeah, I love it!
A lot of laughter, like, oh my goodness. I thought I was going to be
taking it. Yeah, people.
Okay, good. I didn't know these people knew they were part of the deal. But there is now a simple prayer of blessing. I have a question. How do you remember that? Would you pray? Father God, there are two hearts that have managed to find each other in this crazy world. Almost a billion people now. And yet, they find somebody that was as close the hall of high school. And even though they didn't miss those moments, never realizing that the love of their life was only moments away, you graciously have brought them back together to reconnect for them to have the wisdom to hold on tight. It's not always easy to reconnect, but they did. And the first date and the first kiss would lead to another moment and another moment. It's amazing how the days became weeks and weeks became months and months became years. Now, with years behind them, they have the wisdom to make this their now and always. Father, we ask that this not be a two-cord strand, but a three-cord strand, and you're holding them, keeping them, binding them, and blessing them all of their days. Give them long life and good health. Bless this marriage, bless this union as only we can. We lift this up in your name.
Amen.
It's amazing this journey you have. Just as brightness of that sun behind me is coming up with my beautiful angel. This is your day. And I want you to celebrate it all day long. But that celebration will only be dependent of how you answer this question. the I do and I didn't finish.
Alright, let's edit that off. You would think that this man would be your husband.
Thank you.
And we know that she not only takes you, she's also reaffirmed she's taking you as husband. Well then, I guess with the vow set with a fair offer, the I do is done twice. It is my proud privilege as a minister of the gospel to declare that you are now and always husband. I'm going to get out of the way. We need to have that
epic first kiss camera's ready. Kiss the bride.
Yay!
Oh, you hold it right there. That is a beautiful shot.